In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create the scanning effect with glowing edges in After Effects, so let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects. I'm going to use this video of a car as the example, and the first thing I'm going to do is to duplicate this video layer by selecting it, going up to Edit, Duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. Then we need to set the mode of this duplicated layer to a screen. If you don't see this mode, colon, click toggle switches and modes until you do, and set the mode of the top layer to screen or add. I'm going for screen. After that, head over to the effects and presets window, and here we're going to search for several effects and make sure you apply the effects in the following order. The first one is extract, add it to the top video layer, then comes find edges, then levels, then turbulent displace, then tint, and then comes glow. After that, head over to the effect controls panel, scroll all the way up, and here we're going to adjust effects one by one. The first one is extract. Make sure you set all of the values to 0. Now I'm going to move to the start of the timeline, or you can move to the point where you want this effect to begin. Then create a keyframe for white point at 0 by clicking the stopwatch. And I'm going to move 1 second forward, or you can move a bit further if you like that. Then increase the white point to say 200. Then in the find edges, check invert. Then in the levels, I'm going to drag this input white arrow to the left until the lines are somewhat defined. That should be about like 150 range. And I'm going to move the input black slightly to the right to remove some of the noise in the background. So that should be about like 5 or so. Then we're going to move to the turbulent displace. And here I'm going to increase the amount to 100. Then size, I'm going to set it to 20, or you can set it to a bit of a lower number if you want to get a kind of an electric look. I'll keep it at 20. Then I'm going to press U on a keyboard to see the keyframes. I'll move to the first keyframe for the extract, and here I'm going to click create a keyframe for evolution in the turbulent displace at 0. Move to the second keyframe of the extract and set the cycles to 1 or 2 if you want a bit of more movement. I'll set it to 1. And also in the anti-aliasing, set it to high for better quality. Now in the tint, this is mainly to change the color of the lines or the edges to any color of your liking. So something like blue, purple would look fine. I'll go for something like light blue. Click OK. Now for the glow, I'm using the default After Effects glow because I want to keep this tutorial non-plugin. But if you happen to have Deep Glow plugin, feel free to use it because you might end up having better results with it. Now for the default glow, I'm going to start decreasing the threshold until the lines are somewhat glowy. So maybe 15% or 20%, something like that. Then I'm going to set glow intensity to 2. And if the lines appear too glowy, you can always drop the glow intensity to 1 or 1.2. I'll keep it at 2. Then select the glow and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. Now for the glow 2, click the reset button, then for the glow 2, increase the glow radius to say 100. And if this amount of glow is enough for you, that's good. If not, you can always duplicate the glow one more time and increase its glow radius a bit further. Now this glow is enough for me, so I'm going to keep it as it is. And there's one final step here to be done, and that is to keyframe the opacity of this layer so that the edges disappear after some time. Now I'm going to hold shift and press T to bring up opacity on top of these already visible keyframes. And at the second keyframe for the extract, I'm going to create a keyframe for opacity and set it to 0%. Then I'll move 5 or 10 frames to the left. I'll do 10. And then I'll set opacity back to 100. So after doing all that, we can finally preview this effect. So this is what it looks like. And that's how you create the scan effect with the glowing edges in After Effects without using any plugins. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.